coming up on KCTV. You've got to go, but hold on if you can. We'll explain coming up next.
And we'll also meet our first student of the week, because KCTV starts right now. Hey. 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 Chocolate. Chocolate.
Just cast a check, and I'm about to blow it all on chocolate. Yeah, I'm about to blow it all on chocolate. Sweet tooth, baby, make that dollar stretch.
When you need to go to the bathroom, you don't want to hear. You'll just have to wait. I'm Bree.
And I'm Carly. Welcome to KCTV. A classroom's bathroom policy is at the teacher's discretion, but that also creates some uncomfortable moments. KCTV's Brett Ottinger has more.
Here at Centennial, you are often only given a few chances at using the restroom each day. These include the 4-minute passing periods or using a hall pass worth extra credit, which some students really, really need.
Twice from my classroom in a semester.
And then how much extra credit is it?
It's 1 point per pass on the final.
The average high school student should drink between 60 and 80 ounces of water every single day. Athletes need even more. If you follow these guidelines, it is normal to relieve yourself up to 10 times every day. However, many teachers feel like this policy is the only way to keep students in class. Maybe one of the most frustrating parts about Centennial's bathroom policy is how inconsistent it is. Hey, can we interview you about the bathroom policy?
Yeah, sure.
What do you think about it?
What exactly is the bathroom policy?
No, I don't give hall. I give them one hall pass per semester, unless of course they're athletes and they're drinking all the time. Then yes, they get more if they have that, or they have some medical thing.
Depending on your teacher, you might just have to hold it in a little bit longer. Brett Ottinger, Centennial High School, KCTV.
Students, you can apply for multiple colleges with just a few clicks. Here's Townsley's tip of the week.
Hey there, this is another Townsley tip for you this week. We're going to talk about applying on the Common App, and the website for that is www.commonapp.org. So the Common App is a great way to apply to multiple colleges at the same time. What you want to do when you sit down to apply to the Common App is pull the Common App up, see what schools that you want to apply to, and then see what each school is requesting. Some schools will request an essay, some schools will want your ACT, SAT scores. So you want to have those in front of you, and then you'll have to have your academic counselor's email available, so that you want to email them. You don't want to be in a situation where you're applying to schools in January when you're trying to work on senior project and you have all these other things on your plate, because then it will turn into a sufferfest, and sufferfests are no fun. So go check out the Common App, and if you have any questions, you know where to find me. That's it for this week.
Hoping to have some fun under the Friday night lights, then let's travel to CUNA to see the football team in action.
Game tonight at CUNA. Carpool with your friends. Be there or be square. Finally, our student of the week has a kingly manner that would make Henry VIII jealous. Let's meet Royal Madison up close and personal.
Is that Centennial? Hey Centennial, I'm Royal Madison, student of the week.
Well, I like to golf here at Centennial.
Royal was a fantastic student. I hate to say it about him, but he always got his work in, he studied, he worked hard, he was always on task, asked good questions. He was pretty appropriate. Good kid.
And that's KCTV for today. I'm Carly.
And I'm Bree. Have a great day.
You're just too good to be true. Can't take my eyes off of you. You'd be like heaven to touch. I wanna hold you so much. At long last, love has arrived. I thank you.